Right, I'm Terry Cryer. I'm here for the exhibition and I'm doing this appearance for WinkBall.
Okay, Terry, first of all, thanks for agreeing to do this.
Oh, my pleasure.
If you just tell us a bit about how you got started in photography.
Oh, when I was a kid at nine, I got a book out of the school library. I was evacuated to South Yorkshire in this tiny little farming village. I got a book out of the library and it had drawings in it of how to do things. Mm. And there was a little drawing of how to produce a pinhole box. So I got a shoebox and put some tissue paper on the back end, which the old lady I lived with smeared with bacon fat to make it more translucent, and a pinhole at the front. And I stuck it in the fork of a Victoria plum tree. I put my head under a bag and looked at the back of this box, but long enough, and I thought, they've cheated, it don't work. And then suddenly I could see the house opposite, upside down, on this tissue paper. I was absolutely gobsmacked. A kid nowadays, of course, would take it for granted with all this modern gadgetry, but this was, to me, was magic. Mm. And I didn't. The school was just 200 yards opposite, and the bell went for the end of lunchtime. And I was so captivated with my head in this bag, I didn't hear it. And of course, I was late, and I got my arse whacked when I got in from the headmaster for being late. And that sort of imprinted on my mind that I was going to be a photographer. That was beaten into me.
So, you've worked with numerous people over the years. You've done tons. Who have you enjoyed hanging out with? Who have you enjoyed, you know?
Well, I enjoyed all of them because the American black musicians are absolutely fabulous people. But I think the one I enjoyed most, well, apart from Louis Armstrong, that I used to fetch Moroccan woodbines for, and Eddie Condon. Mm. Eddie Condon was a wonderful man. He was West Coast musician. Him and Wild Bill Davidson were two of the finest laughs I'd ever been with. Both raving alcoholics. There was a marvellous instance. He was quite famous with Eddie Condon, and the mayor of Bradford organised a little reception for him. And we're all having fig Newtons and cups of tea, which of course didn't please Eddie Condon or Wild Bill Davidson because they wanted scotch, didn't they? And the mayor's wife came up to Wild Bill Davidson with one of the plates on which the sandwiches had been. And said, "You see the Latin motto, do you know what that means, Mr. Davidson?" He said, "Yes. It means all whores go to Leeds to do business." Which of course went down like a lead balloon. You'll probably edit that out. Which will be a pity. I like Jimmy Rushing. He was a blues shouter. Do you know of Jimmy Rushing?
Yeah,
a blues shouter. A lovely man. Delightful man. They were all nice. Every single one of them, except Miles Davis. He was a bit touchy.
Yeah?
Yeah. Well, he'd had a bad time from Whitey. The copper had smashed him in the throat with a nightstick. Broke his vocal cords, that's why he spoke like that.
Well, I can imagine.
So he didn't like Whitey, and that is quite understandable, and I don't blame him.
Fair enough. So, hypothetically, say your selection of photographs is on fire, and you only save one. Which photograph do you save?
Ooh, Big Bill Brunsey.
Why is that?
Because the night I took that picture, I got pissed with him in the dressing room. And on the way back, my driver, because I didn't drive, fell asleep at the wheel. The car shot off the road, somersaulted half a dozen times, and I had a broken neck.
Oh my word.
So every time I look at that picture, I remember the basket of fruit Big Bill Brunsey sent me, and the telegram. Oh. Which were quite precious.
What do you think the key elements to be a good photographer are?
I really don't know. You've got to be obsessed. Mm. But that won't make you a good photographer, but you've got to be obsessed. I was obsessed with photography and with, particularly with printing. I prefer printing photographs to taking them.
Mm.
Because the magic of seeing a print come up in the developer is indescribable. It is pure magic. And it's organic, unlike digital cameras like this one you're using. They're not organic. Photography is organic.
Mm.
It's flesh and blood, isn't it?
So a phrase that's often used in photography is being in the right place at the right time.
Oh yes, if you're not in the right place at the right time, you ain't got the picture.
Well, what are your thoughts then on modern technology with cameras in abundance, cameras in mobile phones and other devices? Is that the death of the photographer, or is it is it the evolution?
It's the death of the craft. When daguerreotypes came out, which were one-off photographs on a sheet of silver, somebody said it's the death of art, which of course it wasn't and isn't. I think some photographers are saying that this digital revolution, which is quite remarkable, is the death of photography. It's not. It's just that it's such really a new invention that nobody's saw it yet. Nobody's actually, done something truly outstanding.
Right.
But it'll come. But it's taken the craft skill away. Taken the craft skill away. There's no more darkroom work. But of course you work on Photoshop, which is the equivalent of working in the darkroom. But you don't get your hands dirty. It's like working with silver. Handmade silver's a lot better than machine processed silver. Machines that stamp out items. It's not the same as a piece that somebody's worked on, and there are benchmarks. Photographs do have benchmarks.
Okay. How do you feel towards cameras in mobile phones and the fact that anyone could snap a picture which could be worth?
Oh well, it's made photography more democratic, hasn't it? Everybody suddenly is a photographer. I've just done an interview with the local paper, and she said, the journalist, bless her, said we don't employ photographers anymore, we have to take our own pictures. And digital photography, the cameras are so good that you've got to be a complete idiot not to get a picture.
Mm.
It focuses automatically, it sets the exposure automatically, it balances the colour automatically, and you can see the results instantly and take it again if it doesn't suit.
Mm.
No, it's a huge step forward. To a photographer, it's the equivalent of a man standing on the moon.
Oh, that's it.
Oh,
that's
yes.
Significant.
Oh, yes, it's a huge step forward.
Okay. Well, what advice would you give then to a young up-and-coming photographer, someone, not just with a camera on the mobile phone, somebody genuinely wants to go into...
Well, I think what kids don't get in photographic colleges now, they don't get grassroots. And I think any craft that you go into, you've got to learn the grassroots. It's like if you want to be a guitarist, I think you've got to know about Segovia, Django Reinhardt, Big Bill, Brownie McGee. You have to know about all these. Sister Rosetta Tharpe, the first rock and roller, let's face it. You've got to learn about your grassroots before you can advance. And in photography, there's less and less of that in colleges now, unfortunately.
Why?
Well, most of the tutors I've met in art colleges aren't up to it. They've no experience in photography.
Mm.
It can be taught from a book, you know. You can learn to be a photographer in a couple of weeks.
Mm. Do you not think it's a knack? Are you saying an obsession? Is it about putting the work in? And
you've got to be obsessed with photograph. It's about the nature of a photograph. A photograph basically is not about the subject.
Mm.
A photograph's about itself. See, most people, when they're taking a photograph, they see a good subject, a tramp or whatever, gypsies. They say, oh great, up with a camera, click. Well, all we've got is a picture of a gypsy or a picture of a tramp. Well, there's more to it than that. photographs about itself, you must be thinking about the photograph, not about the subject. The subject just happens to be there. Without it, you ain't got a picture. But there's more to it than the subject. It's about the nature of the print. It's a Zen thing, I suppose.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, Terry.
No, no, I hope I haven't made you too confused.
thank you very much. Enjoy the rest of your day.
Yeah, we'll go and get something to eat.